we are out at Kewilliban Dam, just behind to the west of Yandina, and there's a few showers coming behind us on the coast, but just going to go for a little run out here. I've been nursing a damaged shoulder, but it seems to be okay so far, and just giving the DJI Action 4 and Mic 2 another run, and doing a little bit more testing out the scrub and see how they go. State Forest, or a portion of it, runs off Wellington. Nice little ride through here, can get a bit greasy when it's been wet. So since I'm on my own, I'll be taking it easy as well. Mostly twin track through here. Farmland's looking nice and green. Plenty of feed around coming into winter. Or rather the end of summer. This big clay gets quite greasy. You've got to be careful on it. Some Forbys have been through here recently, probably chopped it up. A bit greasy, but not too bad.
thing about a bit of moisture in the track is very little dust. Not that there's anyone behind me, but back again. There's lots of tracks in here. There's you could spend a couple hours in here going around and in circles pretty much, but you've just got to be mindful of horse riders. They often use this area. And our approach to people we come across is to stop, turn off the bikes, and let them make the decision on whether they wish to come past us or us past them. They'll indicate, because they know their horse far better than we ever will. Some of them don't take kindly to motorcycle engines, but it's the way to go, folks. Show some courtesy to them. We've got to share these tracks. The more courtesy we show, the more likely we are to have access to these tracks in the future.
Yeah, the Pocket 3 uses a 1-inch sensor, and it's particularly good for low light situations. But straight out of the box, the colour, the settings are fairly good. You can play around with those should you wish, but I find them pretty good straight out of the box. And the colours are nicely saturated, not too much, and very good camera. I haven't used it much yet because I'm using the Action 4 mostly, in the, particularly on the bike. But this will come in handy in certain situations, especially vlogging. I can't think of a simpler, better camera for that on the market today. And just more experimentation with it, and I think we'll get the best results out of it. So as I was saying earlier, it has the follow me function, which is a fantastic thing. Gimbal keeps it nice and steady. And if you were to be, say you were saying something about your bike, you were moving around, you wanted to point out certain things over here, this will keep you centered. If I was to walk down the track here, it will follow me and keep me in the center of the frame, which is fantastic. When you combine it with the Mic 2, of course, you can go up to, say, a couple of hundred feet from the camera and have crystal clear audio. And these are fantastic things that have been introduced. So you can see it following me now. I'm over the other side of the bike here. Say I wanted to present something and show you something on the bike here, I could, and it would follow me around. Particularly good if I wanted to do a presentation on something. And just a great feature of the camera. So yeah, pretty good, pretty happy with it. It seems to have lost me at the moment, but there it is, back again. No, it's decided to play some games. So I'm just going to walk down into the shadows here, and you can see that it just performs. This is handheld at the moment, so there's a bit of jiggling and that going on, but one thing you've got to be aware of is the up and down motion with the camera. If you're walking, you'll get this if you're not mindful of it. But if we go down here into low light situation, which we are now, it's
its colour and saturation and is just first class. It's unbelievable. I can go into, you know, darker and darker if I went down here a little further. Mind you, I'm not using the camera mics at the moment. I'm still using the mic 2 that's attached to my jacket here. But this is getting quite dark in here. This is a dark little situation, but you can see the clarity. It's fantastic. It's really good. Excellent excellent light, excellent colours, just a fantastic little camera. Here's the little Honda, fantastic little machine. Very, very pleased with it. Very pleased. And of course the Andriani forks and the YSS top spec in the back are still doing their job. Still a magic carpet ride. I'm at about 17,500 k's on the bike now. Just about time for another oil change and filter and a bit of a service. But as far as reliability and consistency of this bike is just first rate. I've seen where there's people saying that it's cheaply made in Thailand and so on. Well, if that's cheaply made, well, I'll be happy to take that every day of the week. If I've got reliability and nothing's gone wrong in 17,000 k's, I don't think that's cheaply made. I'm sure Honda has their quality control all over this thing, and it would be built to their design. So time to get going again. There's a few showers coming in, folks. So I just wanted to give you a bit of a description of this Pocket 3 and what it can be used for. I think it's a great support camera for if you were using, say, Action 4s on a bike ride or on some kind of action. But this camera would capture the post-action times. It will capture, you know, the night activities, you know, the interactions with people after the event really well. So I think the combination between the two would be just perfect, a pairing of cameras. And of course, if you put that with the DJI Mavic Mini drone, I think you've got all bases covered, and that's a pretty good suite to have. I like the amount of torque these little bikes have for, you know, a 286cc engine. You can get to mud holes and what have you and just second gear with a little bit of judicious clutch work, and they'll just torque their way through there. They're very good in that regard. Wet and greasy in here. Obviously doesn't get much sun. turning into Cedar Creek East Road, which takes you up the top of the Mapleton-Fulloolaba stretch. T-bones into that. Nice little bit of wet sclerophyll, or what we often refer to as rainforest, down the bottom here. Car park along here on the side, off the side, just here. This is where I first met several years ago what I now consider a good friend, Wayne Mason, who's ridden with us a lot over the years. This road can often get very chopped up, but they've obviously done a bit of maintenance on it through summer. Seen a lot of red-bellied blacks through, snakes through here over the years. Now the question I'd always ask is how much power do you need to ride tracks like this? And before I go too far, this is only my opinion, folks. It seems you can't have an opinion these days without getting shot down on social media and what have you. However, how fast can you come along a track like this where there's often horse riders, walkers, and other users of this area? You can't. You're just placing themselves and yourself in further risk of an adverse outcome. And I just can't see the point of it. I can't see the point of flying through here at, you know, 80 kilometres an hour. You wouldn't have time to stop if a group of horse riders come round. You wouldn't even have time. We often come up this track at the end of rides just to finish off, and it, you know, brings us a bit further east towards Yandina, the starting point, and usually the finish point of our rides. But if ever you're using this road, please be aware that it's favoured by the horse riders. So keep that in mind before you start fanging it up here. Or down, for that matter. Some nice timber up here as well. It takes you from that wet sclerophyll down the bottom to what's often described as dry sclerophyll up here. And we're getting into black butt territory. A lot of bloodwood. I even think I've seen a gimpy messmate or two through here, but I can't be certain.